Hello, and welcome to the Kato USA YouTube channel. Today, we're going to be taking our 28-888 Mini Diorama Kit and adding the 28-999 Mini Diorama Scenery Kit to the top of it. We're going to be adding some materials for the base, some dirt, some grass, a few bushes, and a tiny tree. And when we're all done, it'll look something like this. First, let's go through what we'll be using to form the base of the scenery. Early versions of our mini diorama kit came with a yellowish foam that you can use to form the base by cutting it and gluing it together. However, to make our kit less expensive, we've actually omitted this on current and future versions and given you the option of what to use. So, let's take a look at a couple of options. On one side, we'll be using Crayola Model Magic. This material is very malleable, very easy to use, and great for scenery and rolling hills. It also comes in a lot of different colors, so you can do a lot of creative things with it. We'll be using brown to make some of the rolling hills on one side of the diorama. And the only disadvantage of using this particular material is it does take 24 to 36 hours to fully dry. But if you've got that kind of time, then this is a great material. Once it's dried, you can sand it down with sandpaper if you want to smoothen the hills out even more. This is an optional step, but I'm very fond of the smooth rolling hills I drive through when I visit family in Ohio, so we're gonna sand these a bit. For the other side, we'll be using green floral foam. This is my favorite material to work with when doing scenery. It's light and easily cut for rocky surfaces and easily sanded to make smoother surfaces like rolling hills. I started by cutting the small foam block in half, since I didn't intend to make anything too tall for this scene. I then line up the foam with the base of the kit and carve a line just a bit out from the edge to leave a little room for error. After cutting it out with a handy box cutter knife, I then do the same thing to a smaller piece to fill in the last gap and glue the pieces together. For this and a few other steps on our project, I'm going to use some Elmer's Glue All. I recommend this over basic school glue, as school glue is thinner, less tacky, and takes forever to dry. Now, we're not going to glue our foam to the diorama base just yet, as we've still got some shaping and painting to do. And that's easier done if you can handle the foam freely. Once the glue has dried, we'll take a hobby knife and start making cuts to form the shape of our land. You can also use a box cutter knife, which I used for the larger, broader cuts. Once we get into carving the more detailed rock face, I'll switch back to using the hobby knife. On the side that faces the tracks, I'm going to leave things a bit rougher, as this is where I plan to include the rocks. Then on the edges, I'm going to make it rounder and smoother for where the grassy hills take over. Before we paint our foam, I sometimes like to fill in its porous surface by brushing on some glue over the areas that are going to remain exposed, like our rocks. Filling in the pores of the foam isn't 100% necessary, but if you choose to do so, I find the paint goes on smoother, requires less paint, and it adds a little rigidity to the otherwise soft foam surface. You'll see I started with the Scenic cement, but I actually recommend just brushing on Elmer's Glue All right from the start, as this is thicker and fills in the pores better. Later on, we're going to cover the foam with materials from our scenery kit, but I find that even the best coverage can still leave little gaps. To make sure those gaps look natural, we're going to first paint the parts where the dirt and grass are going to go a nice earthy brown, and the exposed rock a neutral gray. Once all the glue has dried, we'll apply the paint. This doesn't have to be perfect or fancy, and you don't even need to wait for each color to dry. In fact, it's best to paint them together, so you can blend the colors a bit where they meet. After the base coat of paint has dried, I chose to do one more step to add a little more detail and realism to the rocky surfaces. This step is called dry brushing. Dry brushing is when you dip your paintbrush in a little bit of paint and then dab off most of it on a paper towel. Then, using what little color remains on the now mostly dry brush, you can add little highlights or discolorations to the rocky surfaces. This helps to add depth and dimension to the rocks and gives them an even more natural appearance. For my rocks, I'm going to add a very light gray to highlight the edges. While the paint is drying on the foam, I'm going to take some gray paint and brush around the edges of the diorama base and along the edge of the track to cover any exposed wood for when we glue the foam down. Once the paint on the foam is dry enough to handle, I take some of our Elmer's white glue and secure the foam to the diorama baseboard. You may have seen me occasionally placing one of our small trains on the track. This is to make sure the scenery isn't too close to the tracks so that it would hinder the train from passing. If you've got a little N-scale model, go ahead and take this opportunity to make sure the foam isn't obstructing anything before the glue dries. Now that our model magic has dried and our foam is painted and in place, let's begin adding the components of our 28-999 Mini Diorama Scenery Kit. Starting on the model magic side, I shake up the included scenic cement and then pour some of it into a little container so I can brush it onto the surface. You can use any old jar or container for the scenic cement as it just washes out with soap and water. I'm using an old yogurt jar from a bygone breakfast and some paint brushes I bought from a big box craft store for only a few dollars. Now, the scenic cement has a safety seal under the cap that you'll need to take off. Mine actually came off when I unscrewed the cap, but it got stuck inside the lid. If that happens, just take a hobby knife and carefully pry it out, like this. Being careful not to do this. Lucky for me, there's plenty of scenic cement in the kit, and I still had plenty left over even when finished. Now that the base has the cement brushed on, I cut a small hole in the corner of the Earthvine turf bag and sprinkle it all over the cemented area. This basically represents dirt and will add depth to the grass that we'll add later on. Once you've covered the desired portion of the diorama base, you can remove any excess by tipping and tapping the diorama and then brushing off the tracks. At this time, you can also brush on the scenic cement to the other side. To make sure the rocks show through, I'm not going to add scenic cement everywhere. Once you cover the desired areas, just sprinkle on more of that Earthvine turf, the same as before. As a side note, if any glue or scenic cement gets on the rails, don't be too worried. It wipes off easily enough with a damp paper towel, or if any glue dries onto the rails, you should just be able to scrape it off with your fingernail. Okay, now we're gonna let this dry. Next, let's add our tiny tree, which is a satisfyingly simple thing to do. You can place the tree wherever you like, but I'm going to put mine on the model magic side on top of my biggest hill. To insert the tree, you simply take a toothpick and poke a pilot hole in your base material. Add a drop of white glue to the tree stump for security, and gently press the tree into the pilot hole, and boop, you have a tree. For a super clean look, I took a brush and removed some of the excess glue and added a little extra earth turf to cover whatever glue remained. Lastly, I'll check the distance just to be sure my tree won't hit any passing trains. If the tree is too close, just pull it out and move it over. You can always cover any remaining holes with extra earth turf. Once the earth turf has sufficiently dried, we'll add the green grass fine turf. This will follow the exact same procedure as adding the earth turf, however on my diorama I'm not going to put grass everywhere, and you can also add as much or as little grass as you would like. I'm going to leave the higher spots on the hills exposed, particularly around my tree, as grass typically doesn't grow as thick around tree trunks. Also, I'm going to avoid placing any on the rock surfaces and the edges leading up to the rocks. This way there is a nice transition from grass to dirt to stone. Once again, you'll just need to cut a small hole in the corner of the bag and pour the grass wherever you'd like. One thing I did notice is that the grass turf is a little thicker than the earth turf and tends to come out in clumps, so just be aware of that. Either way, once all the grass is placed, you can remove any excess by tipping and tapping the diorama and then brushing off the tracks. For the last piece of scenery, we'll be adding dark green bushes sporadically to our scene. These will go on much the same way as our earth and grass by adding drops of scenic cement wherever you want the bushes to go and then placing the bushes on the cement. Since the bushes are much bigger than the grass, you can place them by hand if you like. I'll be placing mine mostly in the little valleys between the hills, which will also cover up the cracks left behind from where the model magic dried. I also placed a few bushes near the edges on the slanted parts of the terrain, and for those I used the Elmer's Glue All to help them stick a little faster and stay in place a little better. Again, as with all these steps, you can add as few or as many bushes as you like. Lastly, we're going to take our scenic cement and place drops of it all over the scenery, being careful to avoid the tracks. Placing scenic cement everywhere will seal in all our scenery materials, including the bushes, and will ensure that these elements stay put and are a little more durable when being moved or handled. This scenery kit is a great way to get started in modeling, and you'll notice once you've finished it, there's plenty of material left over in case you want to make another one and further explore what you can do with these small scenes. The dioramas shown here were completed by adults and kids alike and show the only limit is your imagination. Well, that wraps up this tutorial for adding the 28-999 Mini Diorama Scenery Kit to your 28-888 Straight or 28-889 Curved Mini Diorama Base Kit. We've included a complete list of materials used in the video's description, as well as timestamps to specific sections should you need to review any of the steps. As always, thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe to our social media and YouTube channels to see the latest updates on Kato USA's Precision Railroad model products.